Greetings, my scattered brothers and sisters in the Lord. Trust you know the Lord is with you wherever you find yourself scattered today, and that you know that His presence with you is more than enough for whatever you might face today. I continue to think about Elijah and the dead son of the widow and how the Lord worked through Elijah to bring the son back to life. It's in chapter 17 of 1 Kings, and I'll go ahead and start at verse 17. I know you've heard this before, but want to jump in here. Sometime later, the son of the woman who owned the house became ill. He grew worse and worse and finally stopped breathing. She said to Elijah, "What do you have against me, man of God? Did you come to remind me of my sin and kill my son?" "Give me your son," Elijah replied. He took him from her arms, carried him to the upper room where he was staying, and laid him on his bed. Then he cried out to the Lord, "Lord, my God, have you brought tragedy even on this widow I am staying with by causing her son to die?" Then he stretched himself out on the boy three times and cried out to the Lord, "Lord, my God, let this boy's life return to him." The Lord heard Elijah's cry, and the boy's life returned to him, and he lived. Elijah picked up the child and carried him down from the room into the house. He gave him to his mother and said, "Look, your son is alive." Then the woman said to Elijah, "Now I know that you are a man of God and that the word of the Lord from your mouth is the truth." What I want to focus on is back up in verse 21. Then he stretched himself out on the boy three times and cried out to the Lord, "Lord my God, let this boy's life return to him." Now, I just imagine this, that here you have Elijah taking the dead boy and laying him on Elijah's bed up in the upper room and stretching himself out over the boy three times. Why three times? I'm not exactly sure, but I think the three might indicate a thoroughness, that Elijah didn't do this once or twice, but three times he stretched himself out over the dead boy. And so in thoroughly stretching himself out over the dead boy, I wonder if he's thoroughly kind of identifying himself with the dead boy, somehow hoping to thoroughly transfer life into the dead boy. Now, he knows he's not going to do this on his own because he's praying. He's praying for the Lord God to return the boy's life to him. And so it's like he's covering the boy, the dead boy, with his own life. And as he cries out to God, that God would somehow restore the boy's life to him. It's like he's covering the dead boy, maybe even identifying with him in his death, but hoping that somehow death will get swallowed up and life will be returned to the dead boy, and that God will work through this to return the boy to life so that Elijah can give him back to his mom. And so I just keep thinking about this. And in some ways I'm thinking, okay, this is the work of a prophet. That I think about how Moses kind of spread himself out over Israel when Israel was basically dead in disobedience to God, and Moses interceded on their behalf. And it's like Moses was stretching himself out over Israel, kind of dead in their trespasses, praying that God would forgive them and restore life to them. And then I think especially about Jesus and how Jesus on the cross was basically stretching himself out over humanity, that it was the human race that was basically dead in sin. And Jesus identified with us, stretched himself out over us, and is basically crying out to God to restore life to us, to reconcile us, to grant us forgiveness and peace with God. And that God worked through Moses, God worked through Jesus, and God gave Jesus life, resurrected him, and that resurrection life, that becomes hope for us, that we can receive life, that we can receive even now God's Spirit, Holy Spirit, new breath in our lungs. And so I just keep thinking about Elijah and this picture of him, you know, stretching himself out over the dead boy, and how that's the work of Moses in the Old Testament with the children of Israel, and how ultimately that's the work of Jesus with all humanity. And then I think a little bit more about you and me, and maybe that's our work. Maybe there are people that God calls us to stretch ourselves out over, that they're basically dead, that they're lost, And God is calling for us to do very much what Elijah did, to do very much what Jesus did, to stretch ourselves out over them thoroughly, and then to cry out that God would restore life, that they would know the power of the resurrection in their lives and the power of new breath from God, the Spirit, in their lives. And so maybe we are to have kind of an Elijah-like ministry, if you will, where we stretch ourselves out over people and then we cry out on their behalf, on the behalf of others. You know, oh God, return life to them. Give them new breath, fresh breath of your Spirit. So wherever you find yourself scattered today, I challenge you to think a little bit more about Elijah and stretching himself out thoroughly over this dead boy, crying out to God for God to restore life to the boy. Maybe that's the ministry that we are to have today. You know, Lord, who would you have me stretch myself out over and cry out on their behalf that you might return life to them? And then ultimately, Jesus, thank you for stretching yourself out over me. Thank you for stretching yourself out over us while we were dead and crying out on our behalf that we might receive life. Well, wherever you're scattered today, know that one, Jesus, has stretched himself out thoroughly over you, but then also ask Jesus, Lord, who would you have me stretch myself out over today and to cry out on their behalf? God bless. Have a great day. Have a stretched out day. God bless.